And welcome back to this exceedingly down-spiraling playthrough of Pokémon Blue. The original 1998 Game Boy game, which used to be a special edition in Japan, believe it or not, as Red and Green were the first ones to be made. Hey, if you thought my talking about Red and Blue sprites were kinda weird, Japan's Aka and Midori had some insane weirdos in that one. All hilarious, and I love them. Alright, progressing over here. Let's go and— oh, there's a Pokemon coming up! Anyway, there's a Pidgey again. I'm gonna go and destroy him with Galahad, as you remember, wonderful Galahad that was nicknamed by one of our wonderful people. Go, tackle him! Anyway, sorry for digressing. Did you see that cool picture I made in the thumbnail? Did ya? I drew that. I hope to draw more, and I do hope this playthrough will be both informative and fun to watch, so hope to see you there. Oh, Pidgey fainted, Galahad gained 15 experience points, and we're going for real. Out of here. Goodbye, Pallet Town. Remember that, those lyrics in Viridian City? On the road to Viridian City, I left my home. One day I'll be back at Pallet Town, and of course we'll be forced to be back right after we finish the Elite Four. Oh, spoiler there. There is our wonderful waiting for a date nurse Joy with formal gown where I have no idea what's going on here. Someone has to explain this. You know, I know who could. Tamashi Hiroka, I think her name is, probably has all of that covered in her extensive... What do you want, buddy? I'm glad we never even talked to that kid. He's annoying. I'm gonna go to the mart. I'm gonna go and get a little antidote because I'm sure we're gonna need it when we get into Viridian Forest. Wow, that took me a long time to go at. But first, we're gonna get some Pokeballs, because back in the day, they didn't really have Pokeballs. I mean, I know Oak gives it to you in the further and newer editions. They give you always 5 Pokeballs. I think it started in the advanced version. And, that's a good idea, I think, maybe, but it kind of just softens the blow. I mean, it feels like you have to deal with it yourself, and that's what I liked, again, about this version, because I kind of liked the fact that it was all up to you. All up to your exploration and your, intelligence and wisdom to do that. So I'm gonna go to on the left over there to this new route that many people probably don't go to because there's some, I think there's a Nidoran male and female in these grasses, and while I'm doing that, I'm going to see if I can catch something. Maybe there's a Mankey. I forget what there is. I think that's all in yellow though, because I just got a Rattata, but I haven't had any Pokemon yet, so Galahad it is. I'm gonna catch a Rattata. I know it's kind of a common sight in many places, well, obviously, but I always liked Rattata's design. I always liked the purple and the cream color for the underbelly. Just, it fits so well, and of course Rattata's wonderful little albino eyes. It just worked, you know? I mean, just, that's Rattata, and it just, that energy and frivolity. Now, of course, I threw a Pokeball at it. Yeah, look at that! No struggle. Level 4 Rattata. I'm proud of myself, man. Proud of myself. Bites anything when it attacks. Small and very quick. It is a common sight in many places. Yes, we will. Rattata will be called. I love that little icon. Moo Moo Milk Man. That thing looks like a cow. That icon, that's the weird thing. I mean, in Gold and Silver, they updated that, which is very interesting for the capacity of the cartridge when it came to the variety of all the different types in the game. But after the advanced versions, because of course there was much more space, they just overhauled it and put all the little Pokemon symbols on, which is, you know, it's great. And we're gonna call her Mrs. Higsby. Thank you, random citizen. I mean, of course, Mac Wright.
You win!
Oh, it fits. Wonderful. So anyway, I'm gonna see if I can find a Nidoran. Or a Mankey. And in that case, I'm going to approach that direction. Let's see if our Pokemon are alright. This is Higsby. We're gonna switch it. Because we gotta get these things fighting fit.
100% soon, Pikachu.
Okay, let's see what we got. Let's see what we got. Wonderful.
Go, Mrs. Higsby!
Now that back sprite, that melty, horrible, structureless back sprite, how did it happen that this thing just had to look so melty? I mean, you know, I don't think the, I'm sorry, this is a little distracting when you have to play and you have to talk at the same time. How did these back sprites look so horrible compared to the front sprites? I'm guessing another capacity issue. Oh well, then I assume the Game Boy Color cartridges of Gold and Silver had more space. Again, Tamashii Hiroka, she'll know.
Oh... No. No, this isn't... We're not ready. I don't think you're ready. Oh man. I shouldn't have done this. Do I dare skip it? Do you dare see how I fail in this? When I said it wasn't the first time, I wanted to say it wasn't the last time that we're gonna lose... That we're gonna lose to Gear? No, we're gonna win! But... This is not good. I don't have a badge, and the guard won't let me through, which is definitely true, because this is the path to the Pokemon League, which is, I think it's really good to see, like, the ending when you're starting on the map, because it's on the same geographical area. So anyway, there he is, Aaron sent out a Pidgey, level 9, you know, of course. This isn't gonna be good. I don't foresee this being very good, so as I start struggling with this, I'm gonna just mention Tamashii Hiroka. Great YouTube personality. I mean, it's just... you know, she probably has all that covered. All of that wondering of, you know, why Nurse Joy looks like she's wearing a gown and going ready for a date, waiting for someone to come over and pick her up. And all that kind of sprite mysteries that we all are thinking of and all these little coding nitty-gritties. I think Tamashii Hiroka has all this stuff... Definitely logged into her wonderful videos that she does. They're all very crazy amazing. All this insight and all the rumors dropped down concerning the origins of Pokemon, and I'm sure... Oh, see, yep, I'm dead. And, you know, I'm sure you've probably saw her really great videos. She's kind of someone I know. We used to kind of talk through the amazing... Okay, I'm dead. Well, thanks, Aaron.
Yeah, I'm a greater what?
And now I had to give him some money. That was very embarrassing. But anyway, let's continue. Yeah. She's got some amazing videos. I wonder if she's still my friend. Because we used to talk through the amazing YouTube messaging system, and... Hasn't happened for quite a few years. But she's doing a lot better than I am, which is excellent because, you know, I haven't done anything at all. Concerning Pokemon, of course. But, you know, if you haven't seen her videos, which I'm sure you have, here's a link in case you're interested, because it's a gold mine. If you like Pokemon and want to know more about the backstories and all that trivia, check it out. Tamashii Hiroka. Anyway, here's our Tamashii Hiroka. It's a bird. I think we're gonna catch it. Because we wanted to get a Pidgey, and I'm sure Pidgey, when it evolves into a Pidgeotto and then later into a Pidgeot, it could be a great ally to our causes. Because I think those are one of those strong, you know, later on, the next Pokemon formula will continue repeating the cycle of having three bird types, having two normal types that have fangs, you know, and then these common types, such as Rattata, but not as useful like a Bidoof, and all these other creatures. So I'm definitely sure a Pidgey, as we can see here, would be quite useful, and Galahad the Strong, keeping it mighty. Row, fight the power!
Squirt, 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 Squirtle!
There's my- Oh, look! I got it. No resistance.
Which was futile to begin with.
Pidgey, tiny bird, 1 foot. Wings, ground level, kick, blinding speed, whatever. You know, the funny thing about the Pokédex is when I was a kid- Okay, first of all, you have to know what nickname I'm gonna do. We're going to name it...
Bird. Birdy. Bird.
Definitely bird. So thank you very much, thank you very much, Perplexed Cam. Very nice of you.
There, so I'm going to walk up now, because I have two Pokemon.
And now we're gonna see what we're going to see! What we can see. No, anyway, there are these characters here. There's always these wonderful characters like this girl, who's like, Rattata small, how did I know it's a girl? You really want to wonder what those little... What are those, wings? Okay, I just had a revelation. This has not happened to me ever for the past 18 years of the game's inception. This kid has pigtails. little pigtails. And for the past 10 years, I thought they were little wings. I thought they were wings. I thought they were those little floaty arms for tiny children. Not until this very moment did I realize that they were tiny pigtails.
You got it first here, people. That's crazy. I love these nightgowned women. I don't know what's going on. They probably escaped from the castle Anthrax. Okay, so here's Viridian Forests. Tree stumps and a bowl cut kid. You know, I'm actually gonna go back and heal up the team. Don't want to be too headstrong. Now, as a kid, you wouldn't do that. At least I didn't. We just thundered through without proper antidotes. I had a strategy guide, too. Did I read it through? No! Or potions, you know, we would get potions as well. You know, whatever the Pokemon team's health would be. We do this, and we do it now. But now, you're an old man, we gotta do it really carefully. Go back to Nurse Joy, hello there.
Welcome to our Pokemon Center. Heal your Pokemon back to perfect health. Bam, bam, ba-da-ba. Your Pokemon are fighting fit.
Now let me just take a real quick detour to the Viridian Gym. And the reason I'm doing that is because when we were exploring these things as children, I don't know, just I'm always talking about myself whenever you say as children. That guy is bald and he's had his coffee. Or he's sobered up in the Japanese version. Here's Viridian Gym. And it's closed. And that's the interesting thing. As a kid, I would find this as a surprise because I watched the anime before playing the game and I didn't forget the game tips and I didn't know that there was any gym in Viridian. Perhaps because of the anime skipping past that and going directly to Brock. So this was like, whoa, what a surprise, but making it closed kind of gave it a mystery and made it the world feel a little bit bigger in that regard. At least I think so, or maybe I'm talking out of my butt. Anyway, digressing. Viridian Forest is quite a strange and mysterious place. There used to be a little item, I think, somewhere around here, hidden. Now, I usually knew how to avoid all the characters. There we go. There we go. We filled in a little bit more of our Pokeball inventory. See, that's why I think you really don't have to have 5 free Pokeballs at the beginning. The game rewards you for exploring and searching the method instead. That's just, of course, my opinion. Okay, so this kid is turning around. I thought trainers would only do this in gold and silver. gotta evade. Yes. Oh wait, that's not a trainer to battle. Alright, let's go and fight the first guy. Yeah, usually we skip this guy, but yeah. Bug catcher. Very common in Japan. Or at least in the 1970s when Satoshi Tajiri was a child. I don't know about now. Now everybody's catching Pokemon! Ba-dunch. So yeah, I always liked Weedle more than Caterpie, and when I got the red version, it was always Weedle to Beedrill, because Beedrill was, of course, the best wonderful Pokemon. Oh, okay, now Poison, I got a story about this. Now for the sake of explanation, I wanted to show you if Mrs. Higsby doesn't die on us, when I was a kid, there's a story here that I thought my Game Boy was broken. It was breaking down because of the poison. I'll tell you later when this is over. So yeah, I really liked Weedle, Kakuna, and Beedrill. Those guys were just so cool. You know, compared to Butterfree anyway. I mean, I know Butterfree is everyone's favorite, and of course, Buddy's got some psychic moves that are way more helpful, and thanks to the OP nature of psychic in this generation, just a way better option. Yeah, level 5. You know, but Beedrill, man. Bipedal bee with drills for hands. You can't top that great design. Okay, I'll stop gushing. Bird's gonna kill this thing. Well, kill, you know, it's gonna be feigning this thing. Oh yeah, that Pidgey back sprite. I'll keep talking on that all the time, I'm so sorry. You know, just some of the back sprites would look quite different from the ones in terms of design too, I just kinda noticed. I guess the coding that went into this first generation was quite unorganized, and maybe they just had to weave through this complex net of code they worked on, at least in the first generation. Which is interesting because all the actual, for lack of a better word, code for each Pokemon were totally out of order and seemingly random. I guess it was, again, because whenever they finalized the character in this game, that was when they just put the notes in.
I'm rambling again. These battles take a while. Squirtle's face looks like an alien. Also, funny little trivia tidbit. I used to call Caterpie Caterpie because I didn't know how it was pronounced. And Caterpie's gone thanks to a critical. Yeah, cool guy defeated Bugcatcher. Got it. I never understood that until now. He's like, no, Caterpie can't cut it. But I always thought it was like, no, Caterpie can't cut it. It's like, he can't give in. I only got 60 for winning? What's wrong with you? And let's see if we can catch. Okay, so yeah, this is it. Here we go. You see that? As a kid, I thought my Game Boy was just about to break down. Now, Blue is, of course, you know, with a bigger Caterpie encounter rate than Weedle. Which is, you know, not great considering I'd like to get a Weedle, because, you know, Beedrill. Even though Beedrill kind of sucks, I know. I remember going through that lovely little Pokémon handbook you get with Red and Blue in the box, and I was actually nervous because I hoped I could get a Weedle! And thankfully in Red it said Weedle was more common in that version. But it was just so fun how as a kid I thought these things were really hard to obtain, and in that regard, made the adventure of playing this game more realistic. So there you go. Nice little trivia. Maybe going on set isn't the best idea. Anyway, let's see if we can catch a Pikachu. That's what I'm kind of thinking of, you know? Pikachu. Yeah, Pikachu. I never really cared for Pikachu as a kid, honestly. You know, Pikachu, the grand number one Pokemon mascot. Little yellow guy, great color combination. So, I got annoyed in its popularity, I guess. I didn't think it was anything special, and, you know, it didn't feel so special going through Red in 99 as I thought. So I wondered if it was the case that they post-game actually decided on Pikachu as the number one spokes-Pokemon. Years later, my guess was actually correct because I heard that either Clefairy or some other Pokemon would become the general Pokemon mascot way after the game was finished. And in this case, we're talking about the Japanese versions, you know, Green and Red. Oh, an antidote. Again, great level design. Because it teaches you just by your interaction within the game, and when you finish it, you don't have to go through any tutorial because you can, get this, choose not to. Oh, novel. Okay, Metapod. This sprite just brings back some interesting memories. Not really that interesting, but I'll tell you anyway. I mean, what else can I do here? I used to get to play some of the game when it was out on display at local electronic or outlet stores, and usually the game would only be at Viridian Forest, and some people just didn't feel like playing so much of it. There's another Metapod. So this kind of... Wow, this went pretty short. That's all I could say. Just kind of nostalgic. I don't know if I should fight this guy, but if I do, I probably get some... It's gonna get even worse and worse every time I keep trying to do Gust, and it's gonna run out of... P-points. I mean, PowerPoints. PowerPoints? What are they? PP? What are they? I don't know. Okay, so Bird, Gust, critical hit. Enemy Metapod used Harden. Bird used Gust. Gusted up. Hey, this didn't go too bad. I thought this was gonna take, like, 20 minutes.
Metapod, Harden.
There he is, that green sprite. So, which one's the face? Is the nose part the face, or is that part the face? For me, it's always that part that's facing forward, the face. But before that, I thought the nose part was the face, so the part with the really weird horn nose thing. But then, when we saw other pictures of it, and in Pokemon Stadium, they kind of changed it and sort of kept reiterating the fact that that was the front-facing part, the one with the nice little pattern texture thing. Woohoo! Is this boring you or not? Because I'm just trying to find a Pikachu here, and I'm not getting any. I'm just getting...
Caterpie.
That would be a Krabby, wouldn't it? So I got really lost as a kid when I was going through Viridian Forest for the first time because I didn't want to use any strategy guides or anything. I got a potion. That's great. Just kept going through this game very, very aggressively, and I just didn't take care about, you know, the surroundings. But as a kid, it took a while for me to get through Viridian Forest, and I had to use the strategy guide, which I guess kind of sounds like cheating and I'm not exploring that much, but I remember when I got Yellow on the rental Blockbuster, You know, it was all just real exploration. I remember it was just fun to just... Every morning I would wake up and be like, I gotta train my Pokemon! You know, gotta go with Pikachu and find these magical creatures, and it really felt so real to me. Anyway, I'm going back, I'm backtracking to just find... what am I talking about? I'm going to the Pokemon Center to refuel and try to find Pikachu again. Maybe I should just forward this whole part out. But first, I just want to say that it really felt real when I was playing Pokemon Yellow. That was the first time I ever experienced playing the Pokemon games. And I actually kept fighting these, like, Metapods and stuff, and I wanted to capture them because the anime told me to get it all the way down, the health all the way down low, make it faint, and then you can capture it. And I was like, that's super easy. I'll just make it faint. Little did I know, and I learned the hard way. So there's a lot of that sort of exploration and just discovery with this game that I really admired and was really fun in, you know, 1999 when I actually just played the rental version. I was just getting a taste of Pokemon in the Yellow edition. Back to Joy. Goodbye, Joy. So, with that Yellow version, it was like a magenta Game Boy Color, and how great was that? I think I didn't make it all the way until we had to return it, and so it was just the first half, and the first half always to me felt so promising. It always felt really fun to start out and get these little tiny Pokemon creatures, because there were no higher levels or anything, and it felt so, just so inviting and calm, very tranquil, and I think that's what one of the strengths of Pokemon is. It's very, very small scale, very utopian and very just, you know, peaceful. It's very, it's just got all these little things, this childhood sense of wonderment, this optimism, these nice colors, these clean places, these stories that could probably be dramatic. You know, there, you have a canvas for it, you have the palette town for it, you have the palette. But yeah, that to me is pretty much Pokemon in a nutshell. That sort of small, round, you know, very characterized view of a world that you can do tons of things in. I think that's what really made it happen. And here, this guy was such a pain when I was a kid. I couldn't beat him because I wasn't following the rules, I wasn't thinking strategically enough, I was just, let's do it head on, kill him. So this Weedle from a level 9 Weedle, we'll see if we can actually do a lot better than I could when I was, well, 10. I was gonna say 9, but I remember I was 10. So yeah, Bird has to use Sand Attack because now I'm using strategic moves so I can, you know, have an edge on this battlefront, as we could say. Let's see this. Yeah, it's going pretty well. String shot failed, which is always a good thing. For me! Wow, I am actually acing this with a level 5 Pidgey. This has not happened when I was a kid, and I'm just so happy to share this with you and seeing the realization of how not so threatening this is once you... if you just use your head. So Mrs. Higsby's gonna pick up the slack where Bird left off, and he's gonna use a tackle, and string shot failed. Thank you very much. The show is over. Take a deep bow. Bird grew to level 6, and Mrs. Higsby, yeah, level 6 as well. I love this. We're balancing our team. We're doing pretty well, I think. We had a little bit of a scrape with Aaron at the beginning, and we lost a couple of bucks, but I think we're gonna be able to make it past it. And let's just get on up. Let's catch this Weedle since we're already at the end of our good old Viridian Forest adventure, or detour, or misadventure, if you might call it, because I've just been going on and on, trying to find a Pikachu, couldn't find a Pikachu. Let's do this. Let's see if it works. Kiss the Pokeball for luck. Hey! I like how the colors change to whatever you catch. Maybe that could have been an interesting aspect for the design that they could have done for the Pokeball, but of course we all know the black, red, and white, which is a very iconic color. So anyway, we're going to name our Weedle. Since no one talked about naming a Weedle, I'll just do Doofui. Yep, Doofui. Doofui the Beedrill. We're gonna make him a powerhouse in this team. So Doofui, head along onto the front row, and let's get this done. Let's get this over with. Let's head on to Pewter City, but not before trying to hopefully... Never mind. Forget the Pikachu. It's a wasted effort. Doofui's too weak to battle, so I'm just gonna run. We're gonna do some training before we head on to fight Brock. And...
Have you noticed the bushes on the roadside? They can be cut down by a special Pokémon move.
These guys drop in hints, which, again, encourages exploration and the fact that you can learn a lot of things from all the surrounding environment. And here it is, this desaturated gray wonderland we call Pewter City. A place that I really do like. I mean, the level design for this whole area, it's got a really nice balance to it. The city... city in this Pokemon game with a very limited space on the cartridge. It's great, and I'm gonna do a montage. Still grinding, by the way. Grinding away. And the grind was a relative success. Got a lot of unconscious Pidgeys and Rattatas around the field over here. But we have stronger guys to help us in this first battle against Pewter City's Rockmonger Brock. I'm probably over at preparing, because as we all know, Squirtle probably doesn't even have to be half of Brock's Pokemon's level to beat him. But I really want to play this well, instead of how I played it as a kid, which was kind of like Ash in the anime. Anyway, Jigglypuff. Jigglypuff. Always a great moment with Jigglypuff. Kind of, they fixed that in the yellow version. They gave him a unique sprite. So anyway, here we are in Pewter City, and as I said, like, instead of how I played it as a kid, which was, just rocking all over the place and not preparing myself. But then again, that's kind of how Ash was in the anime. Hey. That's how my kids could relate to him, huh? Maybe. So anyway, that place before there... Oh, hello, sir. Yes, I checked the museum. You have to lie to these people, or else they're just gonna keep dragging you along, showing you their wonderful place. I'm guessing tourism isn't very hot over there at the moment. Ah, you see? There's a little bit of plot, you see? You do some exploring, you get some plot in there. Yeah. The museum was up there, and it was great. Pewter City, a stone gray city. Might want to change your description. You don't have to force them to your attractions, Pewter. So anyway, this guy's so great. I love this guy. It's just so weird that he's there. I think he's just... let's see what he says. Oh yeah, Spring Repel to keep Pokemon away. I gotta draw this guy. I think that's what's gonna be the main cover for this underwhelming episode of boring crap. So anyway, without further ado... Let's not talk to people. People want to drag you away. Let's experience Pewter City's wonderful hospitality. And take a look at this kid, who's gonna stop me and going, Wait, follow me! Because this is what Pewter City's known for. It's known for people with quite an overwhelming sense of pride for their city. Anyway, forget it. Rock hard determination or whatever. That was a nice song, by the way. I just didn't get to sing it anymore. Thanks, my friend. And, whoa, he's gone! What happened? People are magic! And this is the first gym. Brock's gym. And I wasn't prepared before. Leader Brock. Oh, it just hurts you in the sides. Now this guy, our good friend, he'll be with us for many, many times. And we have to say, he's such a nice stalker guy. Yeah. I'm no trainer, but I can tell you how to win. Yes, please. Alright, let's get happening. First Pokemon out in a match is the top of the Pokemon list. By changing the order of Pokemon, matches could be made easier. Thanks for the trainer tips. I'm tempted to fight this guy. Yeah, let's do it.
Stop right there, kid. You're still light years away from facing Brock.
Or light years from facing Brock.
Maybe parsecs.
Maybe Googleplexes. This guy's pretty cool. I like him. A little junior trainer. Yeah, let's do it. Diglett. A character we won't be seeing until later. I love the sound of Kakuna. That's a cheap imitation, but yeah. Sorry, we're gonna have to go with Galahad, and he's gonna have to... Should have put him on first. I thought I was on first. Who's on first? Who knows? Now, this is relatively easy because we have, as you know, Squirtle with us. Let's see if we can do it again, or my Pokemon will faint. Should have gotten some potions. I'll get some potions when this is done.
Yeah.
Ooh. Well, look at that, Sandshrew. Look at those beady eyes. What is this? I don't mind it, honestly. I like it in the game, but I don't know if this is, you know, why was it made? Like, who did that? I'm gonna keep wondering this for a long time. So, anyway, let's see if we can get this done. Ouch. I'll leave him. I'm just gonna have to get this really quickly. Hopefully we'll get a critical. It's super effective. I don't think it will survive this one. We will. We'll do it. Yes. Yeah. Super effective. And there we go.
Darn. Light years isn't time, it measures distance.
So he was actually thinking this whole thing through, this entire battle, which is why he lost, because he's, you know, distracted.
I need to show him how cool I am.
Anyway, I'm just gonna forward this real quick. Okay, let's face Brock, gym leader number one. Now, Brock is an interesting guy. I mean, he's a character in the anime, and my perception of that stems from the show because that's the first thing I was exposed to when I was Pokemon boomed in 99. And when I found out that he was the first gym leader in the game, I was like, ooh, will he join me on adventures after this? I imagine a game like that. And to be honest, it's not that hard to do such a game. Multiplayer nowadays. Ideas. Oh, anyway.
I'm Brock, computer gym leader. I believe in rock hard defenses, yeah!
Now, there's people who'd have a controversy over the different types and that gym leaders should be using more types to fight their enemies. And I agree with the fact that it would be more of a challenge, maybe in a rematch mode. I think they did it in Gold and Silver. If not, I'm sure the newer games implemented that. But I think it's good to learn how to fight with different types. And of course, the theming of every gym leader, you know, part of that basic style that I associate with Pokemon, so let's go. Alright then.
Show me your best.
So there he is, without a shirt, some baggy pants, making a crossy cross pose. I really wonder what they were thinking for this game character in particular. The one in the anime is pretty different, and it would be nice to know what made them change his personality, especially if he looks like this, kind of takes someone, you know, like a rock, kind of tough and solemn and stuff. So, let's see what his Pokemon are. The weirdest picture, I'm gonna keep saying this, just so funny, he looks like Noodles, and I totally forgot to, change to Galahad. So, I hope this won't, be a problem, but we'll see. And Defense Curl, which is always a good idea. I'll be using Bubble, because I'm terrified. Alright, well, rock types are a lot better than ground when it comes to getting destroyed by water effects, you know, because we saw Sandshrew. Yeah, this is a little underwhelming. I was a little overpowered here.
Yay!
Dufui grew to level 9. Galahad grew to level 13. Two more levels. Well, three more, and then we'll see some evolution. I don't know if we should. Now, this was intimidating as a child. You see this, and he's like, level 14. Onyx, what? But he's easily defeated because we have Bubble and Galahad with us. And it's kind of disappointing, especially if with the... Ooh, that's a good sound. When it's like that. There we go, super effective, and it was such a walk in the park. I didn't even have to... There we go. He's just the same level that Onyx was when we started fighting him. Cool guy defeated Brock.
If I took you for granted as proof of your victory, here's the boulder badge.
I thought I sounded like Brock before, but I guess I didn't.
There's an official Pokemon League badge.
Woo! Yeah! Flash! Another one of those foreboding things is like, what's going on here?
Wait, take this!
What? Oh, that's right. Technical machines. Now, does anybody ever think about these technical machines and how they look like? Of course, in the new games, we found out that they look like CDs, and it makes sense with all the digital kind of Pokeball information gathering sort of stuff. But, you know, Bide. Bide's a... I don't know if I'm going to teach that or not. Usually I leave them on storage when I was a kid. Never really used them. And let's just have a little talk with our friend here.
Just as I thought, you're Pokemon Champ material. Oh yeah, Pokemon Gym Leader Brock, Wing Trainers Aaron, cool guy.
Cool guy's getting up in the world, heading up. Yeah, and well, before we leave Pewter City, let's just get one of the tourist things done, because they definitely need some of that stuff, especially, as I mentioned before, people dragging everyone over all over the place. So, would you like to come in? $50. Now, okay, this is the museum. The museum was really nice. I really like the idea that you could see some, you know, things like this. Look at that. They even spent the time to put the sprite in there, you know, with all this limited capacity that they have on this cartridge. And you can just look around and see these bald people and observing these fossils. Just made it look more realistic. I mean, realistic, what I mean is like real, like when you go out in real life to look at a museum, and that just textures the game a little bit more. It's to our world, and that's what makes it great. It'd be nice to see, like, a reboot of this game. Now, I know we've had a remake before, but, like, one that has, like, the real thing with lots of galleries and mini-games maybe inside. Oh, Pikachu is here, after all.
Yeah, Pikachu soon, I promise.
It'd be so fun to draw these things and see how they were supposed to look like, at least in your mind, with the geography there. Now, this is the weirdest thing. Talk about, like, fourth wall breaking. First Lunar Land in 1969.
I bought a color TV to watch it.
To write the film out, Moon.
Moon's down.
And another dropping of hints that you know. I love this. Sorry, it's just so pleasant. That's what I like about it. Thank you, sir. And there's these new games that, you know, and later on we'll be going up there. Because, like, the new games have the same thing happening. I just love the banter, the flavor text, all that stuff. It's just makes you happy inside. Yeah, this is gonna be for later. Like a little jump. I would love to go through all these places and look at this with you, but I think we should just keep it going. Nidoran, sit.
Bow bow.
You see, that's the cool thing about that, is like they didn't do that. In the anime, I think, is the first time they had that. Now this guy disappeared, and so we're gonna head on. Well, what I meant about the anime having that was the Pokemon saying their own names. Here it didn't seem like the case. Anyway, let's head on to Route Whatever and see if we can... Actually, no, let's stop here. Next time we'll cross Mount Moon, grab some Pokemon. I got some little tidbits to talk about here and there, and maybe just recap what I like most about this early stage of the Pokemon games. And of course, go through Cerulean, beat Misty. That's how we'll do it. A gym leader, every part. Hopefully I wasn't too boring, and I hope this is getting better. If not, write a comment. In any case, I'll see you later. Oh man, talking so long.